Last lecture, we saw the effect of lattice scattering on carrier mobility in a semiconductor. And in this lecture, we will see the effect of scattering due to ionized impurities on carrier mobility in a semiconductor. We know that in case of doped semiconductor, we have mobile and immobile charge carriers . The immobile charge carriers are donors or donor ions in N-type and acceptor ions in P-type semiconductor. These ions will attract or repel electrons or holes under the action of Coulomb forces. Such attraction and repulsion such attractions and repulsions lead to electron and hole scattering in lattice or crystal. It means electrons and holes are trapped by these ionized impurities and it will decrease the मोबिलिटी ऑफ द कैरियर्स और इम्प्यूरिटी प्लेज सिग्निफिकेंट रोल ओनली एट low temperature. Because at low temperature, electrons and holes spend more time near the parent ion, near the parent ions. Which will decrease the probability of collision. If some temperature is given, then electrons and holes are scattered away from ions and result in reduction in electrostatic force. So, value of mobility will increase if temperature is further increased impurity scattering becomes insignificant and mobility is going to increase with temperature. That is before facing lattice scattering. So let's now draw an impurity atom, and then we will draw its cross-sectional area as I discussed in earlier part of this mobility. So let's take this color. So let's take As plus ion and let's, this is its cross-sectional area. If this is the radius RC, that is critical radius, then there are few cases. If a electron, first let me draw some. Has a kinetic energy that is, if the kinetic energy of electron is greater than potential energy between this atom and this ion and this electron, then there is no scattering. And if the kinetic energy of electron is equal to potential energy of this ion and electron, then there is also not any scattering. But if an electron with kinetic energy less than this potential energy comes in this area, then electron gets scattered in this direction. So this is the case when kinetic energy is less than potential energy. So I think I can change color of this case. So this is the case when kinetic energy is less than potential energy. So let me write these lines. As an electron passes by an ionized donor AS plus ion. It is attracted and thus deflected from its straight path. This type of scattering of an electron is what limits the drift mobility at low temperature. The electrostatic potential energy that is PE of an electron at a distance r from As plus is given by potential energy that is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r and r. So this is the potential energy between electron and this ion. Now, if kinetic energy of electron approaching an As plus ion or arsenic ion is larger than its potential energy at distance r from As plus, then there is no scattering of electron. By this As plus ion. On the other hand, if kinetic energy of the electron is less than its potential energy. At R from As plus, then the potential energy of the Coulombic interaction will be so strong that the electron will be strongly deflected from its path. At a critical radius or distance, when the electron is just scattered or start to scatter. So that critical radius will be RC, or we can denote it by RC, and at this critical radius or critical distance, potential energy should be equal to kinetic energy of the electron, or we know that potential energy is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r rc. So the, as we know, the average kinetic energy at temperature T is given by, that is kinetic energy equal to 3 by 2 kT. So this is the potential energy at a distance RC, and this is the average kinetic energy of an electron. So when electron just start to scatter by the ion, these two energy must be equal. So therefore we know that PE should be equal to KE. It means E square by 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r rc should be equal to 3 by 2 kT, where K is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature. I am not repeating it again and again. So from here we can get RC, that is RC, which is equal to E square by 6 pi epsilon naught epsilon r at. So this is the value of r c, that is the critical radius. And as the temperature increases, we can see from here that is RC is inversely proportional to T. So as the temperature increases, the scattering radius decreases. Therefore, scattering cross section area, cross-sectional area S, is, that is S, which is equal to pi RC square. So if I put the value of RC here, then S would become equal to pi e raised to the power 4 6 pi epsilon naught epsilon r kt square. And from here we can see that S is directly proportional to T raised to the power minus 2. And if tau I, that is relaxation time, is the relaxation time due to ionized scattering then we can write it as tau I, that is due to ionized scattering, which is equal to, we know that, 1 by S U N I, where N I is the concentration of ionized impurities. and this is including both donors and acceptor. So if we put the value of this S, U and Ni in this, then this relaxation time tau I would become, we know that here S is directly proportional to, or I can write it again here, and I that is proportional to 1 by t raised to the power minus 2, and we know that from our earlier calculation that u is directly proportional to t ki half, t raised to the power half, so it's t raised to the power half n I. So here this, it means tau I is directly proportional to t raised to the power 3 by 2 by n I. Here the number of ionized impurities or number of donors or acceptors also depend upon temperature. So, in short, we can write relaxation time with respect to ionic scattering that is directly proportional to t raised to the power 3 by 2 by n I. And here it is important, we can see that and before discussing it, we can write here the value of mobility due to this ionized scattering due to ionized impurity, which is directly proportional to t tau I, and which is directly proportional to t raised to the power 3 by 2 by n I. So this is the dependence of mobility with temperature and Ni. Ni means number of impurities, ionized impurity. So here we can see that mu L decreases with increase in Ni, which itself may be temperature dependent. So the overall temperature dependence of mobility, and here we are talking about drift mobility, mobility due to drift current is given by Matheson's rule. That is one by mu, which is equal to one by mu L, that is mobility depends upon lattice scattering plus mobility that depends upon the scattering due to ionized impurities. So this is the overall mobility of carrier in a semiconductor. And if we know that this mu L depends upon or directly proportional to t raised to the power minus 3 by 2, and this directly proportional to the t raised to the power 3 by 2. So here we can draw a graph. I am writing here again, that is in last lecture we got mu L directly proportional to t raised to the power minus 3 by 2, and here we got mu I that is directly proportional to t raised to the power 3 by 2 by n I. So from here we can make a graph between t and mu. So that graph will look like this. Let me draw you some fancy color. So at this axis it's temperature T, which is increasing in this direction, and here this is mobility mu. So if at some temperature let's say here, and I'm writing it as TH, that is at this temperature mobility has highest value. So if we decrease the temperature from this temperature, there is a decrease in the mobility, and if we increase the temperature from this temperature, again there is also a decrease in mobility. So here decrease in mobility due to t raised to the power minus 3 by 2, and here mobility is directly proportional to t raised to the power 3 by 2 by n I. So in this temperature range here. Value of mobility is altered by impurity scattering. Or scattering by ionized impurities, and in this region mobility is altered by or reduced by lattice scattering. And normally this temperature is near to 500 K, but it's not fixed. It can vary for various materials. So this is about mobility of carriers in a semiconductor, and mobility of charge carriers in a semiconductor. In a semiconductor can be altered by scattering, and there are two types of scattering, that is scattering by lattice vibrations and scattering by ionized impurity.